What does it truly mean to be wealthy? Is it the size of your bank account, the luxury of your possessions, or the prestige of your social status? These questions have puzzled humanity for millennia, but perhaps no philosophical tradition has offered more profound and practical insights than Stoicism. Founded in Athens around 300 BCE, Stoicism presents a radical perspective on wealth that resonates powerfully in our modern consumerism and social comparison era. The Stoics didn't equate wealth with material abundance or external markers of success. Instead, they saw true wealth as an internal state, a condition of self-sufficiency, moderated desires, and inner freedom. The Stoic view offers a refreshing alternative in a world where we're constantly bombarded with messages equating happiness with acquisition. It challenges us to look beyond the superficial trappings of wealth and consider what truly enriches our lives. Wealth consists not in having great possessions, but in having few wants, said Epictetus, a formerly enslaved person who became one of Stoicism's most influential teachers. This simple yet profound statement encapsulates the Stoic approach to wealth. It suggests that true richness comes not from accumulating more, but from needing less. Seneca, another towering figure in Stoic philosophy, echoed this sentiment when he wrote, "It is not the man who has too little, but the man who craves more, that is poor." These words cut to the heart of our modern dilemma. The endless cycle of desire and dissatisfaction that keeps us chasing after the next big thing, never quite satisfied with what we have. But the Stoics didn't just criticize the pursuit of wealth. They offered a constructive alternative. They advocated for a life of virtue, self-discipline, and inner cultivation. "He is the most powerful person who has power over himself," Seneca advised. Pointing to self-mastery as the ultimate form of wealth, this perspective invites us to redefine what it means to live a prosperous life. It encourages us to look inward for fulfillment, rather than constantly seeking it in external circumstances. The Stoics teach us that true wealth lies in our ability to find contentment in the present moment, cultivate wisdom and courage, and live in harmony with our deepest values. In this video, we'll explore the Stoic approach to wealth. We'll examine how to define personal wealth in a way that aligns with our authentic selves, not societal expectations. We'll discuss the liberating practice of knowing what is enough and how it can free us from the tyranny of endless wants. We'll also delve into the counterintuitive Stoic practice of voluntary poverty, a powerful tool for cultivating gratitude and resilience. And we'll explore how to build genuine, lasting wealth by developing our inner resources and living a life of purpose and integrity. The wisdom of the Stoics offers us a pathway to a more prosperous, meaningful existence. It shows us that the wealthiest life is not filled with the most possessions, but the one most aligned with our values, most at peace with itself, and most open to the richness of human experience. The Stoic view on wealth. The Stoics, through their keen observations and life experiences, developed a profound understanding of the paradoxical nature of material wealth. Their insights challenge our conventional notions of what it means to be rich, offering a perspective that is both enlightening and liberating. Let's begin with Seneca, one of the most influential Stoic philosophers. In one of his letters, he writes, "Money doesn't make you rich. These individuals have riches just as we say we have a fever, when the fever really has us." This powerful metaphor reveals Seneca's view that wealth often possesses people, rather than vice versa. Seneca observed that many wealthy individuals in Rome were, paradoxically, among the poorest in spirit. Money had made them obsessive, controlled their schedules, and surrounded them with insincere flatterers. Instead of providing freedom, their wealth had become a burden, enslaving them to constant worry and the fear of loss. This idea is echoed in another of Seneca's quotes. "It is not the man who has too little, but the man who craves more, that is poor." Here, Seneca points to the greedy nature of desire. No matter how much wealth one accumulates, one remains spiritually impoverished if the craving for more persists. Epictetus, another towering figure in Stoic philosophy, shared this perspective. a formerly enslaved person who gained his freedom and became a respected teacher, Epictetus had a unique insight into the true nature of wealth and liberty. He once shared a story about a man who had been offered a lucrative job by the Emperor Augustus. The man came to Epictetus boasting about the money and fame he would gain. Epictetus, however, was unimpressed. He responded with probing questions that cut to the heart of what truly matters in life. "I told him not to touch it," Epictetus told his students. When the man protested that he would make a lot of money, Epictetus replied, "Yes, for little in return." The man argued that many people would learn his name, to which Epictetus asked, "Are you planning to be there every time someone utters your name?" When the man said his name would outlive him, Epictetus said, "So will a rock you carve your name into." Finally, when the man boasted about wearing a gold crown, Epictetus delivered the coup de grace, "And they will put a crown made of roses on you for your funeral. You will look even more elegant in that." Through this dialogue, Epictetus demonstrates the fleeting and unsatisfying nature of external markers of wealth and success. He encourages us to look beyond the surface-level gains and consider the true cost of pursuing wealth, the sacrifices, compromises, and spiritual poverty that often accompany it. Marcus Aurelius, the Stoic philosopher king, also weighed in on this topic. He famously said, "We all love ourselves more than other people, but care more about their opinion than our own." This observation highlights how our perception of wealth is often shaped more by societal expectations and the judgments of others than by our values and sense of fulfillment. The Stoics recognized that true wealth comes from within, from a state of inner freedom, contentment, and self-mastery. As Epictetus put it, "Wealth consists not in having great possessions, but in having few wants." This radical redefinition of wealth shifts our focus from external accumulation to internal cultivation. By moderating our desires, cultivating contentment with what we have, and developing our inner resources, the Stoics argue that we can achieve wealth far more durable and satisfying than material riches. These ancient insights challenge us to reevaluate our modern notions of wealth and success. They invite us to consider, are we genuinely enriched by the size of our bank accounts or the number of possessions we accumulate? Or can we find a deeper, more enduring form of richness by mastering ourselves, moderating our desires, and focusing on what truly matters in life? The Stoic view on wealth offers us a path to freedom. Freedom from the endless cycle of desire and dissatisfaction, freedom from the tyranny of others' opinions, and freedom to live a life aligned with our deepest values. In embracing this perspective, we open ourselves to a form of wealth that no market crash can diminish and no thief can steal: the wealth of a life well lived. Defining personal wealth. In exploring the Stoic perspective on wealth, we now turn to a crucial concept: defining personal wealth. The Stoics recognize that true richness is deeply subjective beyond mere financial abundance. Let's begin with a powerful quote from Epictetus. "Wealth consists not in having great possessions, but in having few wants." This statement encapsulates the Stoic approach to personal wealth. It suggests that our richness is not determined by what we own, but by our relationship to our desires. Consider for a moment what a rich life means to you. Is it the freedom to travel the world? The ability to spend quality time with loved ones? The opportunity to pursue meaningful work? Or it's the simple pleasure of a quiet life, free from financial stress? The answers to these questions will vary significantly from person to person. Some may find wealth in a life of adventure and new experiences, while others may see it in the depth of their relationships or the impact of their work. Still, others define wealth as the freedom to live unburdened by excessive possessions or obligations. Stoics says the richest person is not one who has the most, but needs the least. This perspective invites us to shift our focus from accumulation to contentment. Instead of constantly striving for more, we can cultivate satisfaction with what we already have. This doesn't mean we should abandon all ambition or desire for improvement. Instead, it encourages us to be mindful of our wants and to distinguish between what we truly need for a fulfilling life and what society tells us we should want. The Stoics also emphasized the importance of self-sufficiency in defining personal wealth. Another prominent Stoic philosopher advised, "Make yourself wealthy not by facilitating every whim, but by removing them." This suggests that true wealth comes from our ability to meet our needs and find contentment within ourselves, rather than relying on external sources for our happiness. Consider the difference between someone who needs constant entertainment, luxury, and validation to feel satisfied, and someone who can find joy in simple pleasures, meaningful work, and their own company, who in this scenario is truly wealthier. The Stoic approach to personal wealth also emphasizes the value of intangible riches. Wisdom, virtue, meaningful relationships, and peace of mind are forms of wealth that can't be measured in monetary terms, but are invaluable to a well-lived life. As Epictetus reminds us, he is a wise man who does not grieve for the things which he has not, but rejoices for those which he has. This attitude of gratitude is a form of wealth, allowing us to appreciate and fully experience the richness of our lives in the present moment. Defining personal wealth in Stoic terms also involves aligning our definition of success with our deepest values. It's about creating a life that is rich in meaning, purpose, and personal fulfillment, rather than one that merely looks impressive from the outside. Let's take a moment to reflect on this. What are the things that truly enrich your life? What are the experiences, relationships, or accomplishments make you feel genuinely wealthy? How might your life change if you oriented your pursuits around these sources of genuine richness, rather than societal expectations of wealth? By thoughtfully defining what personal wealth means to us, we set the foundation for a truly rich life. We free ourselves from the endless pursuit of more and open ourselves to the abundance in our lives. Remember, in the Stoic view, the wealthiest person does not have the biggest house or the most expensive car. It's the person who has cultivated inner peace, finds joy in what they have, and lives in alignment with their values. As we move forward, let this Stoic wisdom guide us in redefining wealth on our terms. Let's aim not just for financial abundance, but a life rich in contentment, meaning, and genuine fulfillment, knowing what is enough. In our journey through Stoic wisdom on wealth, we now come to a crucial concept, knowing what is enough. This idea is central to the Stoic approach to living a rich and fulfilling life. Let's begin with an old and profound statement. If you don't regard what you have as enough, you'll be miserable no matter how much you possess. This powerful insight cuts to the heart of our modern struggle with contentment. In a world that constantly bombards us with messages of more, bigger, and better, the ability to recognize and appreciate enough is a radical act. The Stoics understood that the pursuit of wealth, when unchecked, can become an endless and unsatisfying chase. No matter how much we accumulate, there's always something more to want, something else to achieve. This perpetual desire fails to bring lasting happiness. It can rob us of the joy and contentment available in the present moment. Consider the wisdom of Seneca's observations. It is not the man who has too little, but the man who craves more, that is poor. This reframes poverty not as a lack of possessions, but as an insatiable desire for more. In contrast, true wealth comes from being satisfied with what we have. But how do we determine what is enough? The Stoics would argue that it's a deeply personal question that requires honest self-reflection and a clear understanding of our values and needs. For some, enough might mean having sufficient resources to live comfortably and pursue their passions. For others, it could be the ability to provide for their family and contribute to their community. The key is to define enough based on our genuine needs and deepest values, rather than societal expectations or fleeting desires. Epictetus offers guidance. He is a wise man who does not grieve for the things which he has not, but rejoices for those which he has. This attitude of gratitude is a powerful antidote to the perpetual craving for more. By focusing on and appreciating what we already have, we can experience a richness that no additional wealth can provide. There's a well-known story that illustrates this point beautifully. At a party, the novelist Kurt Vonnegut informs his friend, Joseph Heller, that their host, a hedge fund manager, had made more money in a single day than Heller had earned from his wildly popular novel Catch-22 over its history. Heller responds, "Yes, but I have something he will never have enough." This anecdote captures the essence of the Stoic approach to enough. It's about something other than accumulating the most, but recognizing the sufficiency of what we have and finding contentment in it. Another Stoic philosopher advises, "Make yourself wealthy not by facilitating every whim, but by removing them." Knowing what is enough isn't just about setting an upper limit on our desires, but actively working to moderate and refine them. By cultivating contentment and practicing moderation, we free ourselves from the tyranny of endless wanting. We create space in our lives for what truly matters: meaningful relationships, personal growth, contribution to others, and inner peace. Remember, it's about balance, using wealth as a tool, not letting it master us. If this resonates with you, explore further. Dive into Stoic literature, both ancient and modern, and please share your thoughts in the comments. How do these ideas connect with your life? What challenges do you anticipate? If you found value here, consider subscribing for more explorations of philosophy in everyday life. Your support helps us continue this work. Thank you for joining me. In the words of Seneca, the greatest wealth is a poverty of desires. May you find richness in simplicity, strength in self-mastery, and fulfillment in living your values. Until next time, live well and prosper in the truest Stoic sense.